Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share an updated version of the side French braid. Let me know what you think about this version down below in the comment section. If you're new and you haven't subscribed yet, make sure to subscribe, click that notification bell, then you'll be notified every time I post a new video. And let's get started. The first thing you'll want to do for this hairstyle is part the hair in a deep side part. I've placed mine on the right side. This will put most of the hair on one side, so you'll have more to work with for creating the braid. Now divide out a small section of hair from the nape of the neck on the right side. Bring this underneath the rest of the hair and tie it together with another small section of hair on the left side of the neck. This is a little trick to ensure this hair that is usually shorter than the rest doesn't slide out of the braid throughout the day. Now divide out any hair that you'd like to leave out to frame the face. Then pick up a small section of hair on the left side of the part and divide it into three smaller pieces for the braid. Begin by crossing the side strands once over the middle strand. Now begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid to create a French braid. Cross one side over the middle, pick up a new section of hair from next to the braid, and cross it over and into the middle strand. Then cross the other side over the middle, pick up a new section of hair, and cross it over and into the middle strand as well. Since you're crossing the side strands over the middle strand, this is what will create the French braid effect, so the braid is kind of going inwards instead of popping out. And you're going to repeat those steps, continuing the French braid down the left side of the head. So you're crossing each side strand over the middle strand while also picking up new sections of hair from the head and bringing them into the braid by crossing them over and into the middle strand. So cross one side over the middle, pick up a new section of hair from next to the braid and cross it over and into the middle strand. Then cross the other side strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over and into the middle strand as well. On the top side of the head, you'll be bringing in the hair from along the part line first. On the bottom side of the braid, you're bringing in hair from along the hairline. And once you've brought in hair from along the top of the head, you'll start bringing in hair from the right side of the head. So you'll begin pulling in hair from the top of the head on the right side and slowly work down the head so the hair is being swept around the head and brought into the braid on the left side. From the bottom side of the braid, once you've brought in hair from the ear, you'll begin bringing in hair from underneath along the sides of the neck. The more you do this style, the more comfortable you'll get figuring out how and where you bring in hair so the style lays the way you like it best. So just continue bringing in pieces into the braid until all of the hair from the head is combined into the French braid. So cross one side over the middle, pick up a new section of hair from next to the braid and cross it over and into the middle strand. And once you've brought in all of the hair, continue braiding the rest of the section down to the ends in a regular three-strand braid. Now take a clear elastic band and tie off the bottom of the braid so it doesn't come loose. At this point, you can leave the braid just like this, or you can go back over the braid and make it wider so it looks fuller. In order to do that, pinch and pull on the sides of the braid so the hair slides up and out of the elastic band just slightly. The more you pull, the bigger the braid will be, but then you run the risk of it kind of falling loose. So just decide how much or how little you want to pull it out. Work your way up the braid, and when you get to the top part where the braid has hair brought into it, only pull on the small loops of the braid that are near the center. If you pull on the entire section, including the hair that's being brought into the braid, it'll loosen the braid too much and the entire style will become a lot looser. This style has become such a classic. I always love recreating and wearing this style. Let me know what you think about this look down below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments section what you think about this type of hairstyle. Be sure to like and subscribe if you're new. Click that notification bell as always. Then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.